Flying over the holidays is never fun, but these tips should help to keep your journey as stress-free as possible. My first tip is to book a morning flight or as early in the day as you possibly can. Nobody likes getting up at 4 a.m. to catch a 6 a.m. flight, which means that the airport is going to be less busy early in the morning than it will later in the day. Booking the first flight of the morning also reduces your chances of a delay, since the airplane is likely at the airport overnight, as opposed to being flown in from another airport. If your flight is canceled or delayed, you have a good chance of being rebooked on the same day, given you have the whole day ahead of you. If you have an afternoon or evening flight, you may have to spend the night at a hotel or go back home, only to come back to the airport for a new flight the next day. Regardless of the timing of your flight, check the airport wait times at security before you leave your house. If you are traveling from a US airport, check out MyTSA for up-to-date wait times at your departure airport. If you are departing from outside of the US, I like MyFlight, where you can get the wait times by airport and by checkpoint worldwide. I'll leave a link to MyTSA and MyFlight, as well as any other resources that I mention in this video, in the description below. If you are driving to the airport, my next tip would be to take a picture of where you park your vehicle. Make sure that within the picture you have a photo of the sign, like 10A, that's going to identify where in the parking lot you are parked. You may think you'll remember, but I swear something magical happens when you tie in the stress of the airport and then also coming back home, especially if it's at night. It's always good to know where you parked and have the photo proof. Also, take a moment to take a photo of your luggage. This is always an important tip, but especially on travel days when the airports are especially busy. More people mean more bags and more of a chance of yours getting confused with someone else's or being lost. If you were to lose your bag and you go to Lost and Found, the first thing they're going to ask you is, what does your luggage look like? Having a photo is going to be the most helpful thing you can do in this situation. You will likely have plenty of time to wait in the TSA or security line. Use this time wisely and get yourself prepared for when you do reach your turn. Have your laptop and any other electronics ready to be pulled out of your bag, as these will likely need to go through the security scanner separately. As you approach your turn, you're also going to want to remove your belt and then empty your pockets. Or in my case, I wear a jacket and I actually stuff my pockets full of my electronics, my watch, my ticket, anything that I'd like with me. This way I just take my jacket off, put my whole jacket through the scanner, and it's going to keep all of my things together so I won't forget anything, as well as hidden, which is going to reduce any chances of theft. Take a look ahead and see if the people in front of you are taking off their shoes. I used to always have to take my shoes off, in which case I would say, untie your laces and be prepared in advance. However, I've found that a lot of the airports lately, I haven't needed to remove my shoes. I'd love to know down in the comments what the last airport you were in was, and if they had you remove your shoes when you went through security. If it is your first time going through TSA security, or if you just want a refresher or want to be up to date on any new regulations that have been put in place, I definitely recommend you check out a video by Travel Tips by Laurie. I'll link it in the description, but she does a fantastic job of walking you through exactly what to expect step by step at the TSA security. It's also just a lot of fun to watch. Cool channel. There's a lot of people, it's bound to be stressful, but remember, as you go through security and through the airport in general, to slow down, take a deep breath, and take your time. You definitely don't want to forget anything at the security belt, and then if you're asked any questions, don't get flustered, answer them directly, and if by some chance you do need to have additional screening, just go with the flow. Fighting it or being rude to the agents is only going to make it a worse time for you and also going to take longer. Thanks so much for watching, and safe travels. Bye.